Hi everyone, welcome you all. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to handle alerts in iOS app. So as a first step, we need to have a simulator. So you can use RPM desktop client to launch a simulator. And we should also have UI catalog app on that particular simulator. And once you have done this, we'll see how we can handle the alerts by using RPM code. So before that, let me just launch my Mac OS. So here, so as a first step, we need to launch your RPM desktop server client. So using this, we can launch our simulator. So if you just go to start server, click on the start server, it will start at my server, RPM server. And if you just go here, start inspector session, click on the start inspector session. So then it will open up the inspector window. So where I already configured my iOS device, which I have saved under capability sets. So if you select this particular option, so here, these are the capabilities I have saved earlier in the last video. I have shown you this. So once you click on the start session, then it will launch the simulator. Let me just click on the start session and then we'll wait for a few seconds. So I'm just clicking on the start session. Now I'm just minimizing this particular window and let's wait for a few seconds. It will launch our simulator. Then it will also install a UI catalog app on the iOS device. So let's wait for a few seconds. Now it is launched my simulator. And it will take few seconds of time to launch completely and install UI catalog app. Let's wait for a few seconds. Okay, now we can see my simulator is completely launched and it is also trying to install UI catalog app. So once it is installed, it will also open the UI catalog app and we can also see the screenshot. So let's wait for a few more seconds and it is trying to launch your UI catalog app. So once it is launched, my screen will be changed. Okay, so now I think it is still launching. Okay, so now we can see UI catalog app is already started on my iOS device. So here you can see the new screen, where it is capturing the UI catalog home screen. So this one we can use it for to identifying the elements. We can capture the locators. So if you just notice this particular window and UI catalog home screen is captured in this particular window. All right. So if you just go to this particular app, so let me just click on this alert views, right? So there is an option called alert views. So let me just click on this alert views. And here it will show you different type of alerts, simple alert, okay, cancel, other text entry and text, secure text entry. The different type of alerts are there. So if you just go to simple alert and it will give you simple alert, which contains only okay button. And I can close it. And if you just go to the second one, okay, cancel, and it will also give you one more alert window, which is contains cancel and okay button. And we can also use either cancel okay button to close this alert window. And if you want to capture this message, we can also capture it. And there are some other type of alerts also there. So for example, if you just go to other, there are different choice one, choice two, choice three. If I click on this, it will give you one more alert window, something like this. So there are different type of alerts are there. So now I'm going to show you this one. So okay, cancel button, how we can close the alert window by using okay button and also by using cancel button. So how many elements we need to identify here is, first we need to identify this alert views. And we need to click on this and then I can just click on the OK cancel, right? So now let me just go back to your Eclipse. Now I already opened my Eclipse. So this is our new project which I have created in the last video. So this is my package. Under this, we already done one example here, right? In the last session, I told you how to identify the elements. So let me just expand this particular package. Just a second. All right, so this is a example we have done in the last session, identifying elements. So if you see this particular code, so in the same code, we have specified the desired capabilities as a first part. And after that, we have just captured all the elements, all these things. But from this particular code, I'm just capturing this piece of code, guys. So click on alert views. So we have also seen how to identify this element and how to click on this element, right? So I'll just copy some piece of code from this particular program. And then I will add some other some piece of code to handle the alerts from the pop-up. Okay, so what I can do is I'm just creating a new class take the new class. So inside this new class, I'm giving some name called alerts example. Alerts example, let's say alerts example. Okay, so alerts example. So now let's take a main method, then finish it. So once we created a new class, I am now capturing some code from the previous example. So these are the desired capabilities we have created in the last session, in the last video. So here we specified automation name, platform name is iOS platform version, and a device name and app location, all these things, right? The same code we required here. So let me just copy till here and then paste it over here. Okay, so now I just captured only capabilities part from my previous program. So just add this one as a exception. So what this particular code will do is it will go and launch my iOS, and it will also install this particular app, UI catalog app, on my iOS device, and it will also launch that particular application. So now we need to continue the code. So we need to handle the alerts now. So as soon as we have launched this one, first we need to click on the alert views, right? So this is the one we need to click. So for that, what we need to do is we need to identify the alert views. So how to identify the alert views? Let me just minimize Eclipse for now. So we are going to use this particular desktop, APM desktop inspector, to identify the elements. So here we already captured the home screen. Now let me just identify the alert views option. So click on alert views. Now it is giving some accessibility ID and expert. So you can just use one of them. So accessibility ID will be used most of the time. So I'm just capturing the accessibility ID. So once I captured this, now I'm using this accessibility as a locator. Now go back to your Eclipse. So here in my Eclipse, just a moment. All right, so in my Eclipse, I'm just going to identify that element by using accessibility ID. So let's write one more line here. Okay, so now here I'm writing driver dot find element by accessibility ID. All right, so here I can specify the accessibility whichever I capture from the UI. And here we need to perform the click action. So this will perform the action on access alert views. It will basically click on the alert views. So once it is clicked on the alert views here, right? So then next thing is we need to just go in here and we need to click on the OK cancel, right? So this is the option we need to click, then it will open up the alert window. So now we'll see how to capture that particular element. So OK cancel button by using APM inspector. So if you want to capture the latest fresh screen here, we need to just refresh here, refresh source and screenshot, and then you will get the latest screen from your application. So now it is giving the a new screen. So again, identify the element. So this time we need to identify OK cancel button, right? So here there is again one more accessibility ID is available. Let me just capture this element. So accessibility ID, and I'm using this to identify the OK or cancel button. Now again, go back to your Eclipse. So here on your Eclipse, let me just minimize this. So on your Eclipse, you need to use accessibility ID to click on this particular OK cancel button. Okay, so just a moment. Let me write a script for clicking on OK or cancel button. All right, so now driver dot find element by accessibility ID, and in the double quotation, specify the accessibility ID and dot click. All right, so dot click. So this method will perform the click action. So once you click on this, so then again, you will get one pop-up alert window. Now I want to close this alert window by using cancel button. So here we don't have any switching commands. We can directly access this cancel and OK buttons, all these things. So what I can do is now I need to identify cancel or OK button. So I'm just minimizing my Eclipse and go and open the APM inspector. Now I need to again get the latest screen. Now again, refresh your APM inspector. Then you will get the latest screen along with the alert window. So now you captured the latest screen. Now I want to close this window by using OK button. So let's inspect this OK button. Now it is giving accessibility ID is OK. Now if I inspect the cancel, it will give you cancel as accessibility ID. So we can use one of the option to close this alert window. So let me just take OK. So this is your accessibility ID of the OK button. I'm using that as a locator. Now again, go to our Eclipse. So let me just go to our Eclipse. And now we need to write one more statement to close the alert. So once we click on this, we will get the alert window. Now we need to close this alert window by pressing OK button. So for that, we captured a locator called accessibility ID that is OK, right? So now we'll see how we can do that. Okay, so now let me write the statement. Let's say driver.findElement, again by using accessibility ID, specify the accessibility ID that is OK dot click. So this will go and click on the alert window. So it will press on the OK button. Again, it will come back to the main screen like this. Okay, so this will exactly use OK button to close the alert window. All right, now again, one more round I'll do it. So again, I will click on this OK cancel button. So this is again round one. So first round I have clicked on OK cancel OK button. So this time I will click on the cancel button. So just one more round, I will again click on the OK cancel here. And this time I will close alert window by using cancel button. So again, copy the same code. Let me just copy from here. Right. So now again, I'm clicking on OK cancel button. This time I will close the alert window by using cancel. So we already seen the accessibility ID of the cancel button is cancel. So this time, instead of accessibility ID is OK, this time I'm using cancel. Let me copy the same statement. Now instead of OK, I'll say cancel. All right. So before that, I'll put some wait time here. Say dot sleep. I'll just wait for 5 seconds. Okay. So now add this exception. Add through declaration, and after this also I will wait for 5 more seconds. Thread dot sleep, and here I'll say 5000 milliseconds. So we need to add our exception properly. All right, so now exception is added. So the first round I'm just clicking on this one, OK or cancel, then again closing the alert window by using OK button. And second round again I'm clicking on OK cancel, and this time I'm closing the alert window by using cancel option. Okay, now we'll see how we can do this. So here also I will put some time, thread dot sleep off. Let's say 3 seconds are enough. Let me 3000 milliseconds, thread dot sleep. All right, so this is my script, guys. So now let me execute and see. And before that, just make available your simulator. And our code will again install our UI catalog app on my iOS device, and rest of the code will be executed. Now let me execute my code. So after that, I will also quit from the browser. Let's say driver.quit. So this command will be quit from the application. So now let me execute run as Java application. So once we have started running, it will go and install the UI catalog app once again on the iOS device. So now it is installing UI catalog app on my simulator. So once it is installed, it will launch the UI catalog app. So now it is launching my UI catalog app. So once it is launched, it will click on alert views. So first round, it will click on alert views. Now first round, it will click on OK cancel button. Then it will open the alert window. Now again, close that alert. Second round, again, it will click on OK cancel button after 5 seconds. Now again, open the alert window, again close the alert window by using cancel button. And finally, after 5 seconds, my script is executed and exited, right? So this is how we can just handle the alert windows. So here we don't have any switching commands like Selenium. So we can directly identify the OK cancel buttons and we can handle the alert. So this is how we can handle alerts on iOS device. Okay, so that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.